If you still do not use Vantage software, you lag behind your competitors. The world of rendering and CG is advancing rapidly. If you update yourself and move on with this development, it will affect the quality and speed of your work. In this video, I will tell you about Vantage software and its features. And then we will get to know more about the UI and hotkeys of this software. Hi, welcome to MimViz. Let's start with this question. Why did Chaos Group produce the Vantage software? This company has a very popular product, but to prevent lagging behind the world of rendering, they created the Vantage software, which is a real-time rendering and uses modern technologies such as ray tracing and DLSS. But the most famous and beloved product of Chaos Group is V-Ray. It was so successful that Vlado, the founder of Chaos Group, it won an Oscar for the V-Ray engine in 2017. Or even in 2021, he won the Emmy Award for this engine. All these awards are for the V-Ray effect in the film industry, motion graphics, and special effects. So this company, to prevent lagging behind the world of rendering, produced its new product called Vantage. Although V-Ray supports GPU hardware, but it is still the most used and popular in CPU hardware. It was also difficult to use V-Ray GPU for large and heavy scenes and could not work well in these scenes. But in Vantage, the busiest and biggest scenes, along with the above details, it runs smoothly. In addition, in Vantage, you can have the scenes with the support of 3 DMAX plugins and, of course, using the Cosmos library. Cosmos is a complete library of objects, materials, and HDRIs, which you can use very quickly in Vantage. Even recently, in the second version of Vantage, hyper-realistic character models will be added to this library. But one of Vantage's favorite features is the exposure control and camera settings, which happens in a real-time environment. I will talk more about it in future videos, and I will explain the camera part to create the desired animation output. Always learning and using shortcut keys can increase our speed in the software. So let's go very quickly to the UI and shortcuts of Vantage and get to know them better. The UI in Vantage is user-friendly, so it is easy for us to know it. At first glance, we have 4 main sections that are organized. The right-hand section is organized by environment, lights, objects, and materials. Of course, the scene state section has recently been added to Vantage in version 2. If you want to know more about the new features of Vantage and scene state, be sure to click on the link above and watch the video. But the bottom section is set to timeline and animation editor, which we use to create animation and camera movement from that section. On the left, we have camera, color correction, and render settings, which we will talk about in future videos about the camera part. So don't miss the next videos. You can double click to pin the right or left side settings. But today we want to talk about the top toolbar section. In this section, we have a lot of useful and fast tools. The first section is related to the transformation tool. I click on the select option, then I click on the side table. But I want to select it with its bases. So I click and hold on to this icon and click on the select group option. Now I can select the entire side table and move it around. You are familiar with the transformation tool, that is move, rotate, and scale. But there is another useful section called move pivot, which allows us to modify the transformation process by changing the pivot position. For example, I want to place this object within the radius of the side table. To do this, I place its pivot in the center of the side table. And now I can rotate it. Remember that by right-clicking on any of these objects, you can find access to advanced settings or make changes by entering a specific number. But let me give you a better example of the importance of the position of the pivot in the process of transformation. Imagine that you want to close this door in your scene. Now the pivot can act like a door hinge. All you have to do is put it in the door hinge position and then rotate it. But here, the pivot is in a faraway position. Right click on the pivot icon and click on the move pivot to center of bundling box. In this case, the pivot will be in the center of your object wherever it is. Now it is enough to move it in the x-axis until it is in the hinge position and then rotate it. Now we have a closed door. To work with the transformation tool, you can use snap, world space, or local space for your pivot. In the snap section, you can specify that move, rotate, or scale will be executed with what number in each action. But this icon changes the position of the pivot from world to local. This helps us to be able to use it at a specific angle for the movement of objects. For example, I have a ceiling halogen here, and I want to move it in the path of a sloping ceiling. So I select it, right-click on the rotate icon, and enter the appropriate number for the angle I already know. Now it is enough to change the pivot from ward to local. This causes the axis to change its position and angle according to the object. And this makes it easier for us to place halogen in this sloping ceiling. The next section is the Cosmos browser, which we talked about. And you can quickly use its material object or HDRI library in your project. But the options create cost scatter, create light object, and create scene state are options that have been added to the new version of this software. And we talked about them in the Vantage 2 software features video. So if you want to know more about them, be sure to click the link above and watch the video related to the Vantage 2 features. These features are amazing, and you will use them in your projects. But now it's time to go to the tools shortcut section of Vantage software to know them better and use them in our projects. To do this, I select the mouse and key shortcut from the edit section. And now I go to the tool shortcuts section. Here you can see the shortcuts for all tools. If you want to make a change to that shortcut, just click on it and enter your preferred key from the keyboard. For example, here I use Alt plus R instead of E for rotate. Finally, if you want to return to its original state, just click on the Reset All to Default button. Now that we have talked about Reset to Default, let me add this too. If you have entered a number anywhere in this software and now you want the number to return to its default state, just right-click on the number change arrows. Now that number returns to its default state. In the next video, we will talk about the rest of the tools: camera setting, navigation setting, and render setting. So be sure to follow our next video. And of course, let us know what you think about Vantage software. Thank you for staying with us. Goodbye until the next video.